Experience everything Springdale has to offer. Visit explorespringdale.com or download the new Explore Springdale app. It's the best place to discover all there is to do and see in Springdale. We'll help you explore our many eateries and attractions and introduce you to our shopping, arts, parks, and trails. You'll also find links to our great hotels and meeting venues. Download the new Explore Springdale app or visit explorespringdale.com to begin your Springdale adventure.
Come see the largest pre-owned inventory in Northwest Arkansas.
Whatever you're looking for, you'll find it in McClarty Daniel Country. With 800 pre-owned vehicles at six giant locations in Bentonville and Springdale, there's something for everyone. Plus,
at McClarty Daniel, you're protected.
Drive worry-free for 7 years or 200,000 miles with the MD Pre-Owned Advantage. And when it's time to sell your car, we're ready to buy it, even if you don't buy from us. Have you visited McClarty Daniel Country yet?
Visit us online at McClartyDaniel.com.
What makes Northwest Arkansas stronger? Local journalists.
Without KNWA journalists living right here, important stories would go untold. Our community is stronger with local journalism.
Our community's stronger with KNWA.
to another episode of GMBA. I'm your host, Tori, here with Ree. Thanks for joining us.
It's officially Smile Week here at BAHS, and hopefully you guys participated in Monday's activities. But if you didn't, we have all the info on how you can support Make-A-Wish the rest of this week.
Tonight is Family Trivia Night at 5:30 p.m. in the Student Union, so hopefully your family signed up for that. Also tonight is Dine Out Night at Marble Slab from 5 p.m. to 8 p.m. Again, mention BAHS, and a portion of the proceeds will be donated to Make-A-Wish.
Tomorrow, March 4th, there will be a free Flapjacks breakfast in the Student Union before school. Donations for Make-A-Wish will be accepted. There is also another dine-out night that night at Buffalo Wild Wings from 5 p.m. to 9 p.m.
On Thursday, there will be a Make-A-Wish Gala hosted by BAHS Student Council at Central on Main at 6 p.m. Teachers and staff are invited to attend for a discounted price of $25. And if you know of any local businesses who might be interested in attending, tickets are $45 each or $350 for a table of eight. Dinner is included. If you're interested in attending, email Mrs. Wellborn at cwellborn@baschools.org.
Hopefully, you all signed up for the Silent Dance, which is coming up this Friday in the indoor facility from 7 to 9 p.m. If you can't make it to the dance, you can still be a part of Don't Stop the Music every day this week during both lunches in the Student Union and cafeteria. Pay $1 to skip the song, $5 to request a song, or $5 to play two songs from the playlist.
All right, guys, next up is Surge back with GMBA Sports.
What's up, Broken Arrow High School? I'm Serge Thomas, and this is GMBA Sports. First and foremost, we want to send out a congratulations to our amazing wrestling teams on an outstanding performance this past weekend in Oklahoma City. The number one ranked boys team was dominant yet again and brought home Broken Good evening and welcome to a very special 60th edition of the Wildcat Sports Network. I'm Nick Luttrell. Tonight is senior night and there are several surprises that not even I know about. We reflect back on the nail biter against Van Buren last Friday night, catch up with the volleyball team as they head to the state playoffs, plus as always, Coach Wood will be here to break down the Rogers Mounties. It's Friday, November 1st, 2019, and the Wildcat Sports Network starts right now. Normally we kick things off with Coach Wood, but this is certainly not Coach Wood, and honestly I have zero idea what's going on. Typically I have some form of script that I can reference off of, but today for the first time ever, we are going completely off script and seeing what happens. That's right, unscripted, completely impromptu, starting right now.
You know, I should have really thrown in, like, I'm an idiot line somewhere middle in that paragraph. That would have been great.
That would have been so funny.
So, we had a goal at the beginning of this year. Do you remember that goal? WCSN?
Yeah, try to get an hour long episode.
Yeah, we've always had a goal of trying to get an hour long show for WCSN. We got close. I think we got a 56-minute show.
56, yeah.
We got 53, maybe? That sounds
yeah.
But we've always been right in that range. We've never hit it. So today is the day. We've got to get over the hump. It's senior night. It's a big night, so we've got to do it. So for those that don't know, this show is completely student-produced. Everything they do, Nick's typically in charge. Last year, you were the sole person.
Mm-hmm.
It was only Nick. This year, you've had quite a bit of help. You've had
a lot more help.
Rally stepped up. Matt stepped up. Mm-hmm. They do the recap videos that you see every night or every Friday night. Sam stepped up. Caleb has stepped up. Zach, they do the volleyball videos. Mm-hmm. Graham is actually directing right now, and he directs the volleyball stream. So you've had a lot more help this year.
Yeah.
But this time, this is my show right here. So we can do whatever we want on this show.
Okay.
Starting right now, Graham, roll it.
Oh, no.
This is the high hook shot.
On today's Phoenix News, we'll be showing some highlights of the Phoenix Burner Charity Race, Odyssey of the Mine Haunted House, Cyber Patriot, and more.
Morning, afternoon, evening, or whatever time it is wherever you're watching this. Welcome to the first ever Phoenix News program. I'm Kaden Hernandez.
And I'm Diana Barbosa. We're excited to showcase events that are happening inside and outside our building.
DTSOI held their second annual Phoenix Burner with about 150 participants in the race.
While the participants were persevering through the race, students and staff were on the other side of campus giving out candy to kids all ages known as Trunk or Treat.
Let's take a closer look at what happened.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light?
After the Pledge of Allegiance, the students at Don Tyson School of Innovation were turning calories into cash at the Phoenix 5K Burner Run on October 27th. The fundraiser was put together by the Don Tyson School of Innovation faculty to raise money for their school as well as the PTSA.
Director, so it's a pleasure to help the PTSA here at Don Tyson School of Innovation. It's a fundraiser for the PTSA. I was a volunteer and a race director last year, and this is our second year, so we're just trying to raise funds for the school, for the students, and for the faculty.
11th grader and runner for SHS, Jose Romero, sped past the competition and won the Phoenix 5K Burner.
I did see some competition. I did see two or three people that would give me competition in the race. Just trying to get a good pace and try to get first place overall.
While the DTSOI Phoenix 5K Burner was going on, the DTSOI debate team was orchestrating a trunk or treat, an event where they gave out.
In a time of division within our country, two of our students from the Springdale Public School System have taken the initiative to advocate for equal immigrant rights throughout the entirety of Arkansas.
Arkansas United is a nonprofit organization. It has given essential services, such as legal services. It's advocating for the best rights, equal rights, for the immigrant community.
So I was a volunteer intern at Arkansas United. I actually specialized in the legal department of the organization, which means that, like, when people would come in for their appointments for things like DACA citizenship, TPS, all those sorts of like immigration legal processes, I would sit down with them and help them work through their applications. And I'm also on a thing called the Arkansas United Youth Council, which is a group that works to implement solutions for youth in our schools and get youth more involved in politics.
The movement that has been generated the last couple of years by the Dreamers through the young leaders is very important. Because they came here young. This is the only place that they know. And they want to study. They want to carry on and have that right. With over 50% of the student body at Harbor High School represented by minorities, the work that Eric and Jax do on a daily basis at Arkansas United is crucial to the growth of the Springdale Public School System. And for student leader Eric Soto, a more personal motivation.
With Arkansas United, I was able to find a connection there because my mom, she was separated from me, and she still is, and she might not be here when I graduate. And I want to help others be together with their families and, you know, find them together, and maybe those who don't have a legal status here find a way, a path to citizenship.
I loved being part of that work of, you know, lifting others up and making them feel like they were, like they belonged in our community and like they were wanted.
They are marvelous. I call them my favorite leaders. When I see Jax and when I see Eric working together, it makes me have hope, have a lot of hope in society, and that the near future is going to be good. If we have more leaders like Jax and Eric, surely our future is going to be great.
With an estimated 48% being a minority in Springdale, Arkansas, Jax and Eric have a very simple but inspirational message.
Never give up, to always continue doing what they do, and that no obstacle is too big for them, and anything can be possible if you are determined.
I just want these students to know, like, that they can do the things that everyone else does. Like, that just because they have, like, the status of being an immigrant doesn't mean that they can't go to college, doesn't mean that they can't get a job, doesn't mean that they can't belong in this country just like everyone else. They have, you know, the opportunity to make a change and to be a leader if they choose to do so.
In the words of Athletic Director Wayne Stelic, we are many schools, but one community. And the progressive work that Jax and Eric have accomplished is making progress towards a more equal society. For HBWN, I'm Sam Lewandowski.
Isaiah is a first grader who lives with osteogenesis imperfecta, also known as brittle bones. The school and teachers work together to allow kids who have limitations to have the same experience as their peers and feel safe.
So with Isaiah, we work on things that are difficult for him. So being in his wheelchair, he's mastered most of his wheelchair skills. He can transfer in and out, for the most part, to a level surface or to his classroom chair. If he needs to transfer to the floor, then we work on how we do that. We can lift him into his chair. Now, our school's been very good about, if there's a student or a child at any building, I always try to make sure we do like a wheelchair accessibility. Of course, new buildings have to have a handicap accessible entrance, a push button. But they've also integrated that into primary. They do have a wonderful accessible area that they've made both at the primary and intermediate playgrounds. So it has an accessible surface that's nice and flat. It has equipment that you're able to wheel up to if you're in a wheelchair. You don't have to be able to stand to do those tasks. We have handicap accessible swings. That is good.
One of the primary reasons I was hired last year to perform the job I did was to look after him, because he needs that one-on-one help. And that's a pretty big monetary commitment from the school district.
And with Isaiah, last year his wheelchair was shorter, and so he couldn't fit at the desks like the other children. So so what we did was we took single desks and we took the legs off of them and we shortened them. So his desk was shorter, but he was still participating with his peers in every room.
Not only does Lakeside service the needs of the students, but they also go out of their way to express support and thoughtfulness.
I think from a teacher's perspective, it's always important for a class to feel comfortable, for everybody in the class to feel comfortable and feel like they're being treated equally by the teacher and by other students. When there's not equity within a classroom, I think it really affects learning.
When it starts with the administration, teachers not treating these kids different, and the kids are better to not treat them differently. They just have a lot of compassion, and they don't want them to be isolated or singled out, but they want to include them. If the kids are in the floor, he's in the floor. If the kids are in a chair, he's in a chair. If, you know, they're on the carpet, he's on the carpet. If they're, you know, moved to a different station, then he's with them all the time. So his perspective is the same as the other students. Last year when Isaiah, Wishbone Day. So that's the day where they really bring awareness to brittle bone or osteogenesis imperfecta. And the class, Miss Broughton went out of her way to make sure that the class knew about it and wore yellow in support.
They supported me and told my teacher, yes. And all the teachers in there wore yellow. If they had like a different yellow shirt, like they would wear yellow. Mm-hmm. If they had any yellow, they would wear it for my day.
To put that amount of time into one student is a lot to ask, and I think all the teachers and everybody who worked with Isaiah were happy to do it. And I think that's different about Lakeside, is that there wasn't any eye rolling or, oh, I gotta do this for another kid. It was all genuine.
Jared Pena, otherwise known as Eli, has been serving in the military for 2 years now. As a firefighter in the Air Force, Pena, like so many brave men and women, has sacrificed his life for our country. After being deployed in Italy for a year and a half, Jared is making a surprise return to see his younger sister, Jenica, in the middle of her class at Hellstrom Middle School.
That's kind of weird. Yeah, homework? What's good? How are you? I missed you. Good to see you. You got kind of tall. Good to see you. You not gonna say anything? I missed you. Come here, bring it in.
On the other side of town, Jared's younger brother, Gavin, thought it was just a typical day at Turnbow Elementary, until he too was surprised as he entered his next class.
What's up, little man? Hey, buddy. How are you?
Good.
You made your paper airplane. I'm still working on it. Yours is probably better though. What is that one? I don't think we're allowed to throw it. I don't think you can throw it in class. Hi, everybody. What's up, buddy? Did that surprise you? I've only been stationed in Italy, but yeah. Just Aviano, Italy. It's pretty cool. It's northern Italy, about an hour from Venice. You guys know where Italy's at?
Yeah.
No? Where's it at? Oh, I know you know. Where's it at?
Europe.
Dude's a genius, yes. Oh, yeah, I could probably show you on the map. This is Italy. I live right up here in the very tip top. I'm an hour from Austria and an hour from Slovenia.
While deployed in Avalon, Italy, Jared was ranked A1C, which means he is Airman First Class in the Air Force. And as Jared taught to his brother and his class, he's a constant reminder of why America truly is the land of the free and the home of the brave. Thank you to all of those who bravely serve our country every single day. We should all let this be a constant reminder of how grateful and thankful we should be because of courageous people like Jared Pena.
The Buddy Walk is an annual community event that brings awareness and support to those with Down syndrome and their families.
It's an event where our community comes together with all of our buddies to celebrate them, just to gather, greet, have fun, dance, play games, and just be a part of something that hopefully people will learn something from. I have a 7-year-old boy and he has Down syndrome. We were lost. We didn't know anything about Down syndrome. So when he was 2 months old, we went to our very first buddy walk and it was amazing. And so from then on, it just became part of our family life is every year the buddy walk.
I have a daughter that's 16 years old with Down syndrome. She is an amazing young girl. She has friends. I would have never thought that she would have as many friends as she does. People with Down syndrome are people too. And we just want to make sure that we are including them in every part of our life.
I think that they all really enjoy being the center of attention and they know that this is for them.
Yay and Halen.
All the people that I know with Down syndrome have this one ability that I always think of, and it's love, and showing such caring support to the people around them.
In addition to inclusion and acceptance, the Buddy Walk serves as an opportunity for those with Down syndrome to show off their personality to future employers.
One of my main things right now is knowing that my friends are going to have jobs in the community and that people want them and see that they have these abilities that can bring greatness.
I never thought when he was a baby that this is what there was for him. I was so afraid that he would not be able to do anything.
Thanks to the Buddy Walk and its supporters, there will continue to be opportunities for those with Down syndrome.
Since opening their doors to students, faculty, and families, the Ramey and Woodland Junior High Schools have upheld their Cowboys versus Indians rivalry. The 2021 school year will bring a new era of rivalry between the schools, the Colts, and the Red Wolves.
I have been at Ramey for 10 years, and I think over the years there has been different conversations at various points about changing the mascot. And ultimately, it was the school board's decision. So this year, that topic was brought before the school board, and they voted to not have any human imagery in the mascots. And we met probably 3 times starting this school year, and were able to get it to a point where we had narrowed it down to 3 mascots so it could go to a student vote, student and faculty vote.
So my job as a 7th grade ambassador was to give a voice for 7th graders, I guess. We got the selection of all the options of what people said. We looked through all of those, chose ones we all liked, and we all spoke about why we liked those or why we disagreed with others about liking them, just narrowed it down to some.
I kind of just like talked to other students to hear their opinions on it. I asked them, like, what do you think of these 3 options? What would you like to vote for? Is there any options or any mascot names or mascot ideas that you'd like to give? Just hear different students' opinions.
I think the students in the future will like the change. There's gonna be probably some that don't, but like I think the majority will, because it's new and exciting and you should be proud to be whatever your school mascot is.
As the year progresses, we will see new images redesigned to fit the mascots, including sports uniforms, logos, and more. For the Bulldog Weekly, I'm Abby Brandon. Back to the desk.
Ecstatic about the Dubai opportunity. I think what we're looking forward to the most is not just competing against other teams, it's meeting people from all over the world and different cultures and backgrounds.
I knew it'd be exciting, and I knew there'd be nothing quite like. This group has grown, and we have kind of a core group, and that a lot of that core group's who's going to Dubai.
When we first heard that we were chosen to be Team USA in Dubai, there was kind of this whole, we don't know who's going to be Team USA, because I mean we have so many great team members and we can only have 5 members on Team USA.
So the first Global Challenge is an international robotics tournament that includes 1 team from each of about 180 to 190 countries.
So it was really exciting to find out that the 5 seniors who won Worlds this past season are going to be Team USA. But I think what we were most ecstatic about is when they called our name at that baseball stadium, and we were just like, it's us, it's our time to shine, let's get out there on that field, shake some hands, take some pictures.
This group has grown, we have kind of a core group, and that a lot of that core group's who's going to Dubai. What a way for them to kind of get closer to the end of their robotics career here, and us to get to go halfway around the world and celebrate all we've accomplished, and hopefully show the world what we can do.
So I've tried basketball and discovered that maybe that's not the best option for me. I then moved to baseball, which probably wasn't my strong suit.
Come on, Electro, you gotta get over there and protect her!
I found out the hard way, through Max Salinas, that wrestling just plain hurts. Volleyball takes way too much coordination and quick reflexes. So this time around, I decided to dial it back and try something a little less strenuous and a lot more laid back, being a Silver Star dancer. But what I soon discovered is that laid back and less strenuous is anything but the words that would describe this young group of ladies. Led by first-year head coach Don Rhodes, this group of girls are taking their performance to a whole new level, which we see delivered every Friday night.
I've got to be in a straight line or the flag's not going to be straight. So, yeah, Chandler, y'all get in a straight line. Okay, okay, y'all stretch on your own and make sure Nick knows what he's doing over there, okay?
Gotta reach. Come on, girls.
For these girls, practices are Monday through Friday and start dark and as early as 5 a.m. To top it off, Coach Rhodes demands perfection from these ladies. Coordination, tight formations, a sense of rhythm, timing. Not to mention athleticism is crucial in being a member on this elite team.
So what you're going to do, jump split, is you're going to jump up and your legs are going to split this way.
Right. Should I do right leg forward or left leg forward?
Right.
Okay, all right.
And then you're going to split on the ground.
Okay, okay, right.
You may have to slide into it.
Okay.
I'm not sure your first time.
Okay, all right.
Okay, so.
Okay.
And you may just want to do like a little one and try it.
Okay,
your
all right.
first time.
Okay.
You may catch off.
Yeah,
girls,
sure.
Y'all keep working.
Sure.
Okay. 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2. That's good. And then you slide out.
And then slide out.
Yeah.
Okay.
So I'll go 5, 6, 7, 8. Go 1, 2. 3,
okay.
And then land on 3.
Okay, all right.
Okay, and okay. Remember to smile.
Okay.
You always have to smile.
Okay, all right.
Okay?
Okay.
5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3. Woo! That looks good.
I should have known that dancing was no exception to the high expectations. But thanks to senior co-captains Ashlyn Steele and Natalie Luttrell, and even sophomore Reese Bell, they gave me the much-needed confidence boost for their biggest routine to date. And this wasn't just for me. It was for America.
Good. Kick to your nose. Good job, Nick. Kick him to your nose. Pull out.
Stretching, high kicking, camaraderie, spirit, the American dream. It was finally time for me to prove once and for all, that this was a sport for me. And for our statewide known high kick routine, there was only one way to prove it. Yeah, that one hurt. But maybe that's just what it takes to be an elite member of this team. As they say, no pain, no gain. And at the end of the day, I may not have been ready to be a Silver Star, but I found out that dance is no different than any other sport. It requires hard work, practice, talent, dedication, and a desire to occasionally make sacrifices for the betterment of the team. I may not have received a position on the team, but I did limp away with a newfound respect for what these ladies are all about. For WCSN, I'm Nick Luttrell. I bless the USA.
Bryce and Jackson Cockerell have been mainstay names for the past 4 years of wrestling, and now the triplet sister Alex is joining the new girls wrestling team for their inaugural season this year.
something that I love and that I'm really blessed that I actually have two brothers that wrestle. And now that we all do the same sport, I think that's really cool. My parents like it too. My dad was really excited when I decided to actually join.
Everything at our house is usually always involved with wrestling, and we just talk about it quite a bit.
I mean, it's a difficult sport due to like a couple things. Like, you have to be, like, pretty mentally strong to go in there and, like, not have been eating for, like eating how you're supposed to for, like, the past week and have a good practice and, like, still be able to, like, work on your craft to get ready for that tournament coming up. And I just feel like people can't handle that always.
I thought it was a really cool thing that our school incorporated it into our athletic program just because we always want to do new things here, especially girls wrestling, because it's growing everywhere, college, high school. Next year, 4 years from now, it's gonna be huge. So I'm really excited for it. I really love it, and I love all my teammates and my coaches. It's definitely different from anything I've ever tried before, but I am super familiar with the sport and everything around it. So I'm glad I did it, but I'm super excited to see what it brings this year. Watching my brothers wrestle their whole life has helped me a lot, just because watching it and doing it are two very different things, but once you get in there, you're like, oh, I kind of understand this because I've seen them do it before.
My sister just comes up to me like at home, and she'll ask me like if they worked on like some move that day. She'll just come in and like ask me for some pointers on it. She'll come there and say like, this is what we went over today. Can you like teach me like how to do this? And I'll just work with her on it.
They just help me all the time, but my dad helps me mostly too. But I'm really glad that I actually have the opportunity. Like, I can go home and ask questions. I have people to help me.
It gives us something to like bond over, to connect over. We're all working towards like the same goal now.
Lakeside and Hanamaki Higashi have had a sister city relationship, but this year was a little different. Lakeside had the opportunity to host our sister city baseball team. They created bonds that would last forever through their love for baseball.
We would be out here for 5 or 6 hours practicing at a time. They never stopped. It was a sprint nonstop. That's not something we see in America a lot. We may be out here for 5 hours, but it's not a sprint for 5 straight hours. Those guys would go.
Drew the baseball.
離れたまんまで振ると結局不自然な動きのまま振ることになる。
I learned a lot on and off the field. They had a really amazing coach. He was a genius, and the way they played just inspired me.
My biggest takeaway would have to be just how they played the game, because they played it so fast and with such a respect. Every time they walked off the field, they told the field thank you for, I guess, being here. But they just had so much respect.
Baseball was the thread that brought these two teams together to not only learn more about the game, but about each other.
The biggest takeaway would be how two teams, really two worlds apart, were so similar. They work extremely hard. The two teams seem to mesh really well after a few days of working together, and it's just, I think it shows how when you work for a common goal, people are going to come together and be able to build those relationships that bring them closer together.
Whenever we actually knew that they were coming, I was kind of like shocked, and I thought that they were like going to be like superstars, like people in the major leagues, but they came over here and they were just like us. They were just high school baseball players.
Despite the language barrier, they were able to come together as two teams that love the game of baseball.
We definitely, throughout the week, we created a bond that I think will last a lifetime. It's something that like it was really special to me. And at the end, Matsumoto, which was like my guy, he really felt like a brother to me.
In the beginning, it was kind of hard, but as the week went along, our bonds definitely grew stronger. And at the end of the week, it really felt like a brotherhood.
野球ではあの非常にバッティングのことをですね、レイクサイド高校に教えていただいて、すごく勉強になりました。あの私生活あの、普通の生活ではですね、いろんなあの触れ合いの中で、レイクサイド高校の方々によくしていただいてですね、本当にあの今感謝の気持ちでいっぱいですし、なんかこの交流の大切さを改めて学びました。
And once the week got on,We all of us grew closer, and instead of us being like from Hanamaki or from Lakeside, it was all like we were just one big team, one big family out there on the field.